Whether you want to add breathing room around content, change elements' position, increase or decrease elements' sizes, margin and spacing will be your go-to tool to do it all. My name is Lisa, and welcome to Learn with GemPages. In today's video, we're going to learn to use margin and padding effectively, not only to bring out the sophistication of your online stores, but strengthen your brand identity. You can use the timestamps listed to navigate this video. Let's dive right in. Margin and padding. Before we go into details of spacing with margin and padding, we need to understand what is a box model in CSS coding. The box model is essentially a box that wraps around every element, which consists of margins, borders, paddings, and the actual content. The actual content of the element is where text and image appear. Padding is the transparent space between an element's border and content, a border that goes around the padding and content. Finally, the margin is the transparent space around the element's border. Spacing and padding share certain similarities and achieve the same results. In some cases, it might create confusion. So in today's video, we're going to look into four main visual effects, including changing elements' positions and sizes, adding white space, or overlaying contents being made by using spacing and padding. Further than that, we'll learn how to tell the difference between them and incorporate other features for desired results. Change elements' positions. By clicking on the element from the left sidebar under the Design tab, select the Spacing section, and you'll find the margin and padding of the element. Now, we can use margin to move elements up or down on the page, as well as left or right. Let's move this description element to the right. You just need to increase the left margin. In other words, the outside spacing on the left of the element is wider than it pushes the element to the right. With text elements, padding has the same outcome. However, it's a different story with button elements. Instead of moving the element to the right, it increases the size of the button. We'll be going to it soon enough. My recommendation would be to use margin to change elements' position. And alignment will be super useful to position elements in a straight line or create symmetrical designs. Adjust element sizes. When you increase the padding value, the content will stay the same size, but add more size around the content. That's why with button elements, using a margin to move the element around is the only option. Besides changing padding values, we can use font size to change the element size as a whole when the content is text-based. For image elements, there's a dimension section for us to add its height and width. Add white space. A good design should be able to guide customers to the target content that makes the message stand out and easier for customers to come to purchase decisions. Using margin to set the distance between nearby elements is a helpful device to bring out the clarity and readability of your website. Overlay contents. One of the most practical applications of margin is that we can use them to overlap another content. By combining a picture with text, not only do they create a nice contrast between the color of the text and the image, but also capture the customer's attention on the title. Let's put it into practice. We're going to add the background for the headline by clicking on the Design tab. Under Background, at Color, we can choose a color that provides high contrast with the text. Now we're going to select the Spacing section and the negative margin value on the left. We can add value on the right to balance the headline width. Make sure you'll hit Save and Publish to preserve your work. If you have further questions, please leave them in the comment section below and give it a thumbs up. That helps the video be seen by other people. Make sure you've subscribed and hit the notification bell. Then you won't miss out on any future content. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you at the next one. Goodbye.